All right. Well, it looks like we are streaming live on Facebook. Hi, everybody. Yeah, so we're streaming. My name is Renee, and I work for Girl Scouts, Spirit of Nebraska in Lincoln. And this is Global Week with Girl Scouts, Spirit of Nebraska. And today we're going to be talking about how to participate in Global Girl Scouting without buying a plane ticket. So people love to travel. I love to travel. People love to travel, but not everybody can afford it. And that's okay. There's lots of things you can do to participate in Global Girl Scouting without traveling. So there are three packets that we're going to review today, and we're going to do a couple activities for that packet. And so you guys will kind of see what it involves. And there's some really cool activities that you can do. And I have Kat on the call with me. She's going to do some of these activities with us as well. So if you see her pop up, say hi, Kat, and she will be helping. All right. So the first packet we're going to be talking about is the Global Action Days patch, Global Action Days toolkit. And that's what this is. I know it's backwards. But we're going to start off. It's basically, so what happens is you celebrate three of these Global Action Days that are in this packet, and there's 10 Global Action Days that you can participate in. And then after you've done three, then you get a special patch. And I used to have the patch floating around here somewhere. The first activity we're going to do is for Daisy Browning Juniors, and it's for Global Poverty Day. Global Poverty Day is designed to raise awareness of the need to eradicate extreme poverty around the world. So it's basically talking about what is poverty. So what you do is you mark your meeting space, and we're imagining that we're meeting at a regular Girl Scout meeting, but you might be able to adapt this for virtual. So if you agree, you move to one side of the room. If you disagree, you move to the other side of the room. So here's one statement you can agree or disagree with. Poverty is not having enough money to eat two meals a day. Agree or disagree? And if you want to, you can type in what you think in the comments if you agree or disagree. Poverty is not having access to clean water and sanitation. Do you agree or disagree? Poverty is not being able to have a voice in my community. Poverty is not being able to vote in elections. Agree or disagree? Poverty is not having a doctor or a nurse that I can go to in my area. Agree or disagree? Poverty is not being able to afford the bus fare to visit a relative in another town. Agree or disagree? So you ask the girls to share why they agree or disagree with each statement. And then together you write a group definition of poverty. So what is poverty? The girls will help describing it. So useful questions are, is poverty always about money? Is there a connection between poverty and having control over your life? Is there a connection between poverty and feeling safe and secure? Is there a connection between poverty and the environment you live in? So this is that, and then at the end, you can read some books together. There's some suggestions on books you could read to help girls further understand poverty. So that's a Daisy Browning Jr. activity for Global Poverty Day. The next one is super cool, and it's from World Thinking Day. And of course, most of our members are familiar with World Thinking Day. So World Thinking Day, this one is an activity for all grade levels. World Thinking Day began in 1926 at the 4th World Conference of Girl Guides and Girl Scouts at Camp Edith Macy in New York. The delegates decided to create a special day when Girl Guides and Girl Scouts around the world think of one another and celebrate our global sisterhood. If you have gone to a World Thinking Day event before, why don't you share what country you represented in the comments and maybe something you learned about them, so we can kind of get back to that feel of global Girl Scouting and celebrating our sisterhood. So the activity is you look at a map and you get a list of all the WAGS member countries. So World Association of Girl Guides and Girl Scouts. And then find countries in WAGS that are at the same latitude or longitude as your council. And I did this activity, but I can't share my screen right now. So I don't know if, Kat, you can help me with that. So what I did is I found that I live in Lincoln. So I found out Lincoln's latitude and longitude were at 40.8 latitude, negative 96.7 longitude. And we
should be able to share your screen now.
We are good to go now. So then I went and I looked for latitude and longitude at 40.8. So I used a different website that helps you find latitude and longitude. And then I went into Google Maps and I typed in the latitude and longitude and I found a couple different cities. So there is a small city in Italy called Sarna. Sarna is at 40.8 latitude and 14.5 longitude. I'm not sure if my screen is working or not. I'm gonna keep going here. So then,
we can see it.
Okay. And then another city I found was called Panjin, China. I probably said that wrong, but I have that pulled up on my map right now. That's at 40.8 latitude and 122.09 longitude. So this is the same latitude as Lincoln, where I live, but a different longitude. I think that's pretty cool. So if I zoom out, here's the city that it's in, and you can kind of see pulling back where this is in China. It's not going kind of slow. Well, that's pretty far north. It's pretty close to North Korea. So as I keep pulling back, you can kind of see that's the same latitude as where I am, which I think is kind of neat. I like maps. I like geography. I like travel. So it's a perfect activity for me. So you can explore all over the world, the latitude and the longitude. And anyone could do this actually at any time. But this is one of the activities for World Thinking Day from the Global Action Days packet. And the next activity we're going to talk about is, I'm just going to leave the screen up because it's for Global Action Week for Education. And it's Global Action Week for Education. Is an international annual campaign led by the Global Campaign for Education with support from UNESCO. Global Action Week for Education raises awareness of the importance of education for achieving sustainability and all of the commitments made by participants to reach the global education goals by 2030. So one of the things that you do is you read a book called Malala's Magic Pencil, by Malala Yousafzai, and many of us know and love her. And this, you can find this book, somebody else reading it if you want on YouTube, or you can see if your library has it. We're gonna watch a short 2-minute preview about this book, so you can kind of understand what it's about and why it's a great book.
My book, Malala's Magic Pencil, is about my story. When I was growing up, I believed in this magic pencil, and then it tells how I found the magic in my voice. When I was was younger, I used to watch a TV show about a boy who had a magic pencil. If he was hungry, he drew a ball of curry and it appeared. If he and his friends were in danger, he drew a police officer. The boy was a little hero, always protecting people who needed help. How I wanted a magic pencil too. Every night before I went to bed, I wished for a magic pencil of my own. And every morning I would wake up and check my cupboard. But the magic pencil was never there. Wishing wasn't enough. Someone needed to speak out. Why not me?
One child, one teacher, one book, and one pen can change the world.
I tell my story because I want more people to read it. There is a lot of serious things and bad things that has happened in my life, from the attack to all these extremists that I have seen in my life. So I wanted to find a way which would make it comfortable for younger children to read it. So I think picture book was the best option. I like each and every page, like seeing myself sitting in that room with my brothers watching TV and seeing those cracks on the wall. Then seeing myself and how my voice was reaching globally to people, and then how I was recovering from the attack. It just tells my story so beautifully that I had never thought of it before. So I'm really thankful to the artist, Karis Kuwait, for their great work. And I hope it reaches as many children as possible. I hope that children who read this book will also realize that they can also find their magic, and it might be in their voice, it might be in their writing, it might be in their art.
Okay. Isn't that such a beautiful video? So I love Malala. She's wonderful. So for part of the requirements for celebrating Global Action Week for Education, you read that book. There's a couple other books you could read as well, but I just picked that one. And that's Global Action Days, a couple activities from that one, if you are interested. We'll share that packet. Anyone can have it. It's easy to get. And the next thing we're going to talk about is the Global Action Day Award. It's an award that you wear on the front of your vest, girls, once you've earned it. So it's an official award that you can earn each year. So this is the Global Action Days packet for Daisies, Brownies, and Juniors. And we're going to be doing a short activity. And Kat, you can help me for this one. Finding out what gender equality means. So part of the theme of the Global Action Day Award this year is gender equality. And first we have to find out what that means, and girls have to understand it. So making a gender equality connection. So what you do is talk about gender. So gender is a social or cultural idea about what boys and girls can or should do or be. So with a group of your friends, make a list, three lists, boys, girls, and both. So then write down things that only girls can do and only boys can have or do, and things that both girls and boys can have or do. So let's think of something that a boy can have or do. What can he have? So a boy can play football. That's okay. A boy can play pretty much any sport. What can a boy not do in our culture? Boys usually can't play with Barbies. So if a boy plays with Barbies, is he still a boy?
Of course he is.
Okay. So what about girls? What can a girl do? A girl can play with Barbies. A girl can
have a baby doll.
Have a baby doll. Yes. A girl can wear princess or unicorn shirts.
Mm-hmm.
What can a girl not do?
Play football.
Play football. Girls usually don't play football in our country. If a girl plays football, is she still a girl?
Of course she is.
Of course she is. So then we have a conversation about differences between boys and girls and what our culture thinks that we can and cannot do. Yes, so we have a conversation around that, and you can draw a picture that represents gender equality to you. There's some cute examples in the booklet about what girls can do or what you can draw. So girls might be a pilot, a superhero, big muscles. Girls aren't encouraged. People usually don't think that girls can have big muscles or women can have big muscles or be very strong. So have a conversation about what does that look like for gender equality.
Right. And we're not saying that girls can't play football or boys can't play with Barbies. It's just the social norms that we've grown up with.
Right. And so what do those look like? And talk about that. So that is from the Global Action Award. Another activity for the Cadet Seniors Ambassadors is a gender playlist. And so basically what you do is you think about music that you listen to that have messages in them about gender, social, or cultural ideas. So how are men and women, girls and boys treated, or how should they be? How does that message and the music have an effect on the way that boys and girls think they should be? So you make a playlist. I'm gonna share with you a video that I love that makes me feel like girls are strong. This video is just a beautiful video of a girl who doesn't care what other people think of her. She will just be herself. And let me see. So it's called Soy Yo. It's all in Spanish. So if you don't fully understand all the words, that's fine. You can get the vibe of the song.
Cuando te pegas fuerte más profundo es el beat, sí. Sigo bailando y escribiendo mis letras. Sigo cantando con las puertas abiertas. Atravesando por todas estas tierras. Y no hay que viajar tanto para encontrar la respuesta. Hey. No te preocupes si no te aprueban. Cuando te critiquen, tú solo di. Soy yo.
Okay, so I'm not going to show you the whole video, but that just gives you a picture of how awesome that video is and how it celebrates a girl just being herself. And I like to watch that one sometimes. It makes me feel happy. It makes me feel proud of girls and being a woman. It's wonderful. So that you can add to your own playlist of songs that talk about or discuss gender or being a girl or being a woman. And then now we're going to do From Where I Stand, and Kat's going to help me with this one as well. This is from the Cadet Senior and Ambassador part of the Global Action Award. And Kat, why don't you, so it's kind of, what you do is can you hold up the sheet where this with the scores? So basically you kind of mark political leadership. Is your president or your governor and your mayor, are they men or women? So then you look at your teacher, your principal, your doctor, different people who are leaders in your community. Okay, thank you, Kat. So you mark that because obviously every community is different. So you're not all going to have the same mayor or even the same governor if you live in different states. Tally that up, and then you fill out the sheet. Kat, if you want to show us your and so then you draw this. So there's 3 women to 10 men who are leaders in your community, right? North Platte.
Yes.
So by looking at that, we can see that you do not have gender equality in the leadership in your community. And again, this will change in every community, but you can kind of see how does the leadership in your community look and where can it be better? So that is from where I stand. It's a very, I think, a powerful activity. What did you think about it, Kat?
I think it's a great visual representation with the graph. I loved it because my girl doesn't even have a head. You know, like she's still just kind of growing there. And it's really easy to forget that we're still trying to get there, that there's still a glass ceiling that we haven't broken through yet. You know, so it's very eye-opening, and I really enjoyed doing it, and it really brought more perspective to how unequal, or, you know, how there's a lot of inequality.
Yeah, still, yeah. Thank you. So Kat was my guinea pig for that. She had not done that one before, so thank you. And speaking of that, I asked her to do another activity. Now we're going to be moving to a packet called Open the Gate, and GATE stands for Girls Access to Education. So I don't have a printout of that, but it's a pretty long one, and it actually is a game. So if you play this, you learn all kinds of things about girls' access to education all around the world and the different things that girls need to be able to access education. So one thing that they talk about is child marriage. The example is girls need community support in order to go to school. And if a girl is married before she's an adult, then that is taking away the community support and often she's not able to go to school. So this is from the packet. Each year, 12 million girls are married before the age of 18. That's 23 girls every minute, one girl every 2 seconds. Think this only happens in other parts of the world. 20 states in the US do not set an age floor for marriage. Only one state, Delaware, sets an age floor at 18 with no exceptions. So then what you do is you use, you go online and there's some guidelines where to go. And so what is your state law for child marriage? What are some other laws around the country? And if you want to, you can look up child marriage laws in other countries. And Kat did this activity and she'd never done it before. And so what did you learn, Kat?
So I learned that in the state of Nebraska, both male and females can get married with legal or with parental consent at the age of 17. If they do not have parental consent, they have to be 19 years old. There are no exceptions whatsoever for anyone to get married below the age of 17. I did find interesting that without parental permission, Nebraska is the only state that requires you to be 19. Most other states are 18.
And what were some of the states that shocked you because it was so low?
Oh my goodness.
Pretty much, these are states that allow child marriage in the United States.
Yes. Yeah, so Massachusetts, a girl can get married with parental consent or the permission of a judge at 12. Boys have to be 14. You're not even a girl's not even a teenager yet. And if they have parental consent, they can get married at the age of 12 in Massachusetts. In New Hampshire, girls can get married at the age of 13 with parental consent and a judge permission. So at least in that state, you have to have two sets of permission. And boys 14 again. In the state of Mississippi, and this shocked me greatly, in the state of Mississippi, there is no age limit. If your parents or you get a permission from a judge, a 6-year-old could marry a 7-year-old. And that to me is just ridiculous. I can't even imagine why anyone would ever do that.
Yeah. So I think it is a very useful activity because people always assume that child marriage is something that happens in other places in the world, but our own laws allow for child marriage in our own country. It's sobering and something that Girl Scouts can fix. And Girl Scouts have advocated for child marriage laws in the United States pretty successfully from what I understand. So that is something that girls can do.
I think this is a call to action for Massachusetts and New Hampshire.
Yeah, and all those other girls that live in other states that, yeah, that don't want to get married that young, right, or don't want to see other girls get married that young. Mm-hmm. Even if it's not actually happening, it's worth changing the laws to protect girls in the future, I think.
I agree.
All right, let's do one more. Let's do the Water Watch one. And so the Water Watch activity. So around the world, girls spend a lot of time doing chores. And obviously, even in the United States, kids do chores. In many other countries, the girls do so many chores, though. They cook, they clean, they gather firewood, and collecting water is one of the biggest burdens for women and girls that keep them from doing other things like going to school. So if you had to collect water for yourself and your family, how would that affect your time? So basically, you go through and you calculate how much water your family uses. And so Kat, you want to talk about that?
Absolutely. So this is what the sheet looks like. It kind of gives you a little table to figure out how many times a day do you do certain things and the total amount of water that you use. So in total, if I do laundry every day, I would use about 87 gallons of water a day. So if, for example, the water well that I have to get water from is 2 miles away, I would have to make 18 trips. This is based on a five-gallon bucket. I would have to make 18 trips to that 2 mile or that well that is 2 miles away to get that 87 gallons. If I average 20 minutes walking with, you know, 5 gallon bucket, you're looking at 12 hours a day just gathering water to use the amount of water I use every day. If, for example, the well is 5 miles away, it would take me 30 hours a day, which there aren't 30 hours in a day, first of all. But that would have me walking 90 miles a day. And if you figure maybe the first trip you take, you only take 16 minutes to get to the well. But after like trip number 15, I'm pretty sure you're going to be dragging a little bit. And it'll take you a little bit longer.
I'm also pretty sure that you would learn how to save and conserve water a little bit more.
For sure. All right.
So that's this is a really great activity just to estimate, both for estimating how much water you use and thinking about water conservation, and also kind of thinking about that sisterhood, the global sisterhood of girls, and how so many girls in the world spend so much time collecting water, the importance of clean water, the importance of having wells in your village if you're living in a developing country, and how important that is. Or even sometimes I see things, little tools or things to help girls and women collect more water or collect water faster, things like that. It makes a big difference in the life of a girl if she can collect water faster or doesn't have to walk so far. So that's that might, having water in her home or in her community might make it easier for a girl to go to school.
Right. And one thing I wanted to say is a lot of the, some of the church groups in North Platte will get together and they'll raise money, and the youth group will go to a village and they will actually raise enough money to dig a well so that the well is in the community. And that really opens up a door for girls in that neighborhood.
It sure does. One well can really transform a town. Yeah. So, and then who knows, and maybe you start talking about raising money for a well for a nonprofit. That would be a really cool take action project. So, all right. So I think that's it for today. It went a little bit longer than I expected, but thank you everybody for listening and watching. And we hope that you can use these examples to participate in Global Girl Scouting, and that you will learn a bit more about the world, even though you might not be able to travel. So we'll post these packets in the comments. So check those out. And thank you very much for listening. And Kat, if you can end the stream, that would be great.
Thank you, everyone.